Salute comrades and welcome to Let's Play Master of Orion 2 Battle at Antares. My name is Vadim and today we're going to pick our race. And we will not pick race from these guys, we will create our own race because we will have problems, lots of problems with our difficulty that we will solve in our unique way. So we'll pick custom race. We will pick Illyrians because they are so beautiful, they like Russian girls. And actually, I've realized recently that my first girlfriend was looks like this woman, like not with violet skin, but with normal skin, but I didn't realize it then, but it was very funny to understand this, talking about imprinting and something. So we will pick Illyrians and we will name our race Russians. I'm not to offend anybody, but just it. So we have options we can choose from, and it's just mind blowing how many options we have. And we have 10 points to distribute on these options. But we can have more points because there are some traits that will. Some penalties that will give us more points to distribute it, to spend it on something else. And first of all, we will talk about government types. Okay, feudal, dictatorship, democracy and unification. Basically, feudal are good in shipbuilding but suck at researching. Dictatorship are something average. Democracy are good in researching and taxing, but it's too costly. 7 points is ridiculous. Unification is considered to be the best race, but six they produce better and grow food better, but 6 points is the last for too much. And I like picking feudal because it gives its penalty type of government, but it gives you a great bonus for your production of ship. So I will pick it. Okay, I guess you understand. Then it's quite funny because unification is a communist type of government, and game developers created in a very good way. I guess they were on this side of politics. But I choose feudal, and they suck at researching. And researching, when I've prepared for this let's play, I've visited the game fact site, and there were a game favorite test question, yes, for Master of Orion, and the authors told that picking the penalties for your researching is like suicide in this game. This was quite funny because this is one of my best pickings, my favorite pickings, or minus one to research, or minus or feudal type of government that gives penalties to researching. And this is quite funny, but you will see how I'll manage to do this. Then let's talk about other things. This is areas of this game you can pick bonus or penalties. So population growth, food production, industry production, and I will actually pick plus one to production. Then science, money, ship defense, ship attack, or ship-to-ship combat, ground combat, and spying. And spying isn't so great in this game, I will pick penalty for. In ground combat, I will rarely need ground combat. I will tell you later why. And then the special abilities. And the special abilities is a thing that will just blow your mind, believe me. This why the race could be so different from each other. So let's talk about them. Low G world and high gravity world. It's something about production and about ground combat, but not worth it because there are technologies that compensate it. So, and they are too costly. Aquatic, it's quite good pick, but there are no that many planets for this type of abilities. So like 10 or 20% and it's too costly, so not worth it. Subterranean allows you to have twice more colonists per planet than normal race would have. So I will pick this definitely, because it allows you to build more men, and for each of these men I have plus one to production. So I will have, it's like almost I have plus two to production. So yes, lots of men, it's good for me. Then, and there will be lots of buildings that will give a bonus to each of your people. So if I have twice more people, then I have twice more bonus to each other, to overall. So this is a very good choice for me. Large home world, rich home world, poor and artifact world. It's about your starting planet, and gives you bonus in the beginning, but then it's nothing. And if I had 3 points, I maybe spend it on this, but I don't. Then cybernetic means, I've already told you about cybernetic and when I discuss mail cars, but I'll tell you once again, they need less food. They need just half of food and half of production. Yes, and I have bonus to production, so I will have lots of production, and I don't regret it. But the main thing, I need less food. So I can send more people on production, I have bonus, that I have bonus in. Yeah, let's see where I'm going. So this is good for me, and they have a bonus in ship-to-ship combat. Then Lit War, they don't need food at all, but they 10 for them, just too many 10. So not worth it. Repulsive, they have no, cannot negotiate, they have no diplomacy at all. And I will need diplomacy just at least for exchanging of technologies. Charismatic is bonus to diplomacy, not worth it. Uncreative and creative, I will talk about that later when I will discuss with you the technologies and researching, but I just will tell that creative is most overestimated picking in this game. The beginners love it, and you can tell if the person is beginner in this game about his thought about this ability. Because the beginners say this is the best picking in this game, and I will tell you this is almost the worst picking of the game, because the 8 points is too many for this. Kill them, tolerant, I will discuss when I will discuss with you. Production, but something in pollution. Fantastic traders about money, not worth it. Telepatic is, I guess, one of the best picking of the game. It's not about like it gives you bonus to spying, to diplomacy, but it eliminates ground combat from the gameplay, because you don't need conquer colonies, you can just mind control them without any resistance if you destroy defending ships. So I guess this is a very good game, good pick for me. You will see later. So it works it totally. Lucky, it's about random events, nothing special. Omniscient, they can see the map from the beginning, like Orion, where the Orion, all the planets, the enemies, very good, but I have no points for them. Stealthy ships are more for multiplayer, so they can be detected, can't be detected. Transdimensional, something about ship speed, not worth it. And Warlord is how many ships you can have. You can have more. So my strategy is to have lots of men that don't need much food and have bonus to all their production. And I will don't need researchers, so I will send almost everybody on the production. So I will just outproduce everybody. So I guess you understood now my strategies. And in my next video, I will actually start a gameplay process. So see you there, comrades, but for now, you are dismissed.